If you want to have happiness, if you want to feel peaceful, if you want to feel strong, you want to feel powerful, then you will have to learn to say no politely. You'll have to learn to say no politely, firmly. If you start saying yes to everybody, everything, every time, you're basically saying no to yourself, your time, your things. And somehow we have this pressure on our mind, on our heart, that how can I say no to somebody? For example, your colleague in the office tells, boss, today, long time, that girl has said, yes, we're going for a date. This work can you do for me? Now you have dosti ka vasta. For a friend, you can't do this much. I can do so much. This much I should not do. Now you have your own pending work which you have to complete, for which your boss will ask report tomorrow. But because you don't have the heart and the strength to say no to your colleague, you end up doing his work also, or take up his responsibility also, or her responsibility also. Now you have to have extra baggage, because of which you go late and your girl get upset. To keep him happy with his girl, you are making yourself miserable with your girl. Ye kidhar ka samajhdari hai? By saying yes to everybody's need, if you think you are making them happy, you are mistaken. It's not about sensitivity, insensitivity. It's about being sensible. And I learned in my life, you want to grow materialistically in life, you want to expand your life, then you'll have to learn to listen no from the world. As a salesman, when I used to go to make my presentation about my product, and I explain the whole thing, they say, no, we're not interested. They're not interested in my product. We take it personally and become miserable, depression. Papa, can we go out for dinner today? No, beta, aaj nahi. They are saying no to dinner outside, not to you. You know how immature we are. We say, Papa always say no to me, not to you. Then why no all the time to me, not to you? You give only ideas which are useless. You give an idea to Papa. Papa, I am taking you out for dinner. Same communication, no? Papa, today I have planned to take you for dinner. No father has ever heard this. You'll take me for dinner? Yeah, Papa, I feel like taking you for dinner. Take him for dinner. You think your father will ask you to pay? And if you don't, now what happens? First time when somebody said no to me, I felt very bad. But then I realized that no is not to me, no is to my idea. So I changed the idea. I presented the way they will like it. In their no, my mind expanded. Listen to me carefully. In their no, my mind look for next alternative. For next alternative also they say no, my mind look for next alternative. For the same next alternative he says no or she says no, my mind asks for what else can be spoken, what else can be done. And like that, for the same thing now, I have 5 ideas. My mind has expanded. It happened because of what? No. Every prospect I met in the sales, I explained them my product, they said not interested. And then I ask, kya hua, kyun nahi hua? And because of this, I come back with a new presentation to the same mistake what I have done with this, what is he had told me no. I'll make the correction, modify my presentation, go to next client. This client also will say no to me. With his inputs, I will make my new presentation. Aise karte karte, after meeting 10 people, the 11th person, because I have given a foolproof presentation, he says yes to me. And that is the rule of market. You want one sale, meet 10 people. All your materialistic success will only come when you listen to more number of no's in the initial part of your life. Nahin. No. Nahin hoga. Not possible. You keep talking some this way, ye approach, wo approach. How many yes you want from him for that? One yes, no. Let him say 99 no's. You want one yes, no. Wait for that one yes. Learn to say no to people and learn to say how to take it from people. And the more and more times people say no to you, it's only expanding you mentally. So for first lesson, let's take it from here. Learn to say no to people. For the quality of life, you'll have to learn to say no to the world, so you have time for yourself, place for yourself, peace for yourself. You want to grow materialistically in life, you want to expand your life, then you'll have to learn to listen no from the world. And at the same time, when the world says no to you, you should know how to absorb it and handle it.